Are you ready for the buzz? The buzz. I am Tatum.
And I am Nunu. Thank you for watching. Yeah, we're gonna cover a lot of stuff today. We got anything from TV to the box office to music to politics. We have a lot to cover today in a short amount of time. I know a lot of people are asking, oh, you guys should talk more about the topics and it should be longer, but y'all know how I roll. I don't like long shit. I don't like hours to talk about different topics, but we're gonna keep everything like we always do. Maybe in the future, we probably gonna do something different. But for now on, let's talk about TV. I watched True Blood. It's finally back.
Yes.
After a whole year of waiting, we finally get a little taste of the nice blood.
This season is absolutely
It started off real good.
Amazing.
It got caught up.
I want to know what's going to go on. I don't know if you guys have been watching the episode, but you know, I went out on Sunday, so I just DVR'd it, and I really want to know what is going to happen with Eric. Eric is the one that bought the house.
Okay,
and he
yeah.
runs Fantasia.
Yeah.
And
he bought the house, and now he built some kind of, you know, dungeon and
coffin.
Well, like, in the house, so
something
it's
like going to
be
that.
Real interesting. If you guys have not watch True Blood. If you haven't watched True Blood, it's probably all over the internet right now.
It's amazing.
Or you can just go to HBO.com or just subscribe to HBO on TV.
Depending on who your provider is, if it's not Time Warner Cable, you can always go to HBOGo.com and you can watch future episodes as well as episodes that have already passed.
So I'm so happy that it's back. You know, real good quality shows instead of just watching reality shows and shit like that.
So, I'm really excited because Harry Potter's coming out. It's the final installment. So, it's a little bittersweet, but I hope it's long. Because the last Harry Potter, the first, you know, the first installment of the two parts for the last, it wasn't long enough. I was sitting there like, oh my God, what's going to happen?
The last Harry Potter was 2 hours and 30 minutes, right?
Yes, that's not, I could sit there and watch Harry Potter for 3.5 hours.
I never really got into Harry Potter, but it's the 7th movie, right? Or 8th movie?
Let me see.
I don't know. But watch Harry Potter, since you say watch Harry Potter, I'm not into Harry Potter, but because when I got introduced to Harry Potter, it was on a 3rd or 4th movie, and sometimes I hate catching up to stuff like that. But watch Harry Potter, because he's a really good Harry Potter fan, and he looked like he could be in the Harry Potter movies.
I wish I could be.
He looked like a character.
They need to send me to London and have me go over there and fake a British accent real good.
Let's talk about music. You said something about Lady Gaga is getting sued.
So we all know about what happened with Japan and the earthquake.
On
the last episode, I was wearing my tank top that said "Love Japan." So Lady Gaga was selling bracelets, Japan bracelets, or I Love Japan bracelets, on her website, on her official website, and all of the proceeds were supposed to be donated to a Japan relief charity or fund. And supposedly, she's been accused by an attorney's office that she was charging unnecessary tax and shipping fees to gain a profit off of these charity funds. And that's illegal, to gain a profit off of something that's being donated to charity.
Charity, okay.
So she's being sued over that.
Honestly, I don't think that she would have done that. Lady Gaga, she give away a lot of money to charity. She's a gay activist. She's so good in what she does as an entertainer. I think probably behind the scenes, they probably have people who like people who's not Gaga, I think people who probably went over what Gaga represents, it's probably someone who, you know, who worked behind the scenes with Gaga doing it. I don't think
that's something that she did personally.
Gaga don't mean,
I think
she don't,
you know, approve, they all have their
Gaga
teams.
Don't approve all the any other, you know, big celebrities don't approve all the legal stuff.
Yeah, so, I think exactly. I think she has a team, and maybe somehow if there was unnecessary taxes charged, or, you know, unnecessary taxes put in place, mm-hmm. it wasn't something from her personally. It might have just been something that dropped the ball. Somebody might not have known the right, mm-hmm. you know, costs or shipping to charge, you know, things of that nature.
Yeah.
So I think that might have been what happened.
Speaking of the music industry, Lady Gaga, she was an underrated artist before. As far as like underground artists, people who's trying to get there on a star level. We discussed this earlier about, you know, underrated artists and how the industry is not like what it used to be.
No.
They have so many underrated artists. List some that you said before. I think JoJo's one. Kelly Rowland was one. I think she's finally trying to, you know, let people know that I am here to stay.
Well, I tend to think that Janae is a perfect example of an artist that's underrated. But what I think is wrong is that I'm not really getting true fans from people anymore. I'm not getting that you're a true fan of the artist, because I feel like a true fan does not download the leaked music. I'm a true fan. I will always be a buyer of the album. Mm-hmm. I will always find, if I'm broke, trust me, I'll scrape up $12 to go get that album, because I'm a lover of music, but I'm a lover of that particular artist.
So the music industry has changed.
Exactly. People have
changed. Of course, I can agree with that.
There used to be days, don't you guys remember those days where you used to wait for the albums to come out, that all you had were just the singles on the radio, and you'd be so excited to go buy the album to be like, oh my God, did you hear this song? Did you hear this song? I still do that.
What about the people that say, you know what, the economy is horrible, I'm broke, I got a job. That means they're gonna be, you know, musicless. They're not gonna be listening to music, and that sometimes that encourages people. Music does motivate people to work out, or music motivates people to push on. What about those people who saying that I don't got no money to buy music, and downloading music keeps me going?
That's a good question. I'm not gonna say that I don't download music. I download music. I download the singles that I hear on the radio, and I make mixtapes. But for some reason, when it comes to an album, I never ever download the album. I never ever download that
like
album
Beyonce,
before it comes out. I will always go and buy the album. Like, yeah. Exactly. I don't listen to leaked music.
The Beyonce, buy the new songs, Beyonce, but the day you bought it.
That's when Beyonce wanted you to have it. Her team put it out on that date for a specific reason. I'm going to wait for when she wants me to enjoy it.
On the news Friday, Prince William and Kate Middleton, I don't know, what kind of person
her sister
is?
Pippa. What's her sister's name?
Pippa. Well, they down here in LA, in Los Angeles. They came out here on July 8th, Friday. This is their first time visiting the U.S. as a couple.
Mm-hmm.
You like the royalty family? Are you that excited about it? Like,
no.
You're not?
Not really.
I love it.
I would love.
No, every little girl princess. Every little girl wishes to be a princess.
I would love for a royal. I love the royal family as far as the history of it and, you know, things like that. But I'm not too like fascinated with the royal family as of now. Now I love Princess Diana. I love going back to, you know, Queen Victoria and watching. Mm-hmm. Emily Blunt play her in The Young Victoria, and I love all of the old history, but I'm not too fascinated with this marriage. It's not something that necessarily moves me. I'm very happy for him. I would love to see them marry a black woman or an ethnic woman into the royal family. Now that's probably not going to happen.
Oh, okay.
But I would love to see them marry
somebody.
Nor dark
be in a royal family.
Exactly. And be about true love and not about politics, so
and
to say.
And what you think that your grandmother might say or your father might say, oh, no. But he did make a smart move by marrying Kate Middleton, because she wasn't born in a royal family. She was a commoner. So that's a good thing.
Okay.
You know, he's dating the middle class. And not middle class, but when she's growing up, But you know, I think they are a prime example of how a family should be. You know, they dated for like 10 years, something like that, and now they finally get married and they're doing good. Now they got really good.
I'm happy for them. It's not.
They show how normal, you know, a couple can be. And I think, even though they're not that normal, they're in the public eye. But we're gonna, in the future, we're gonna do more topics about the community topics and stuff like that. But we want you guys to do email us at contactme@yourboynunu.com, or you can simply comment below or send me a message on Twitter or Facebook. Let us know what you guys want us to talk about. We did a video last week about the Casey Anthony trial.
Yes.
We did that. We disagree on a lot of things and we agree on a lot of things. We want to get it more interesting. And I think each of us can, you know, you guys can relate to both of us. So let us know what you guys want us to talk about. Come on now. We don't want, you know, we can get you guys excited. We want to give you guys some entertainment. I want to interview him. It's going to be a one-on-one with Tatum. Because he's a music. He's a very talented person. I want you guys to get more, you know, comfortable with him and more interested in what he do. Because he do more things other than, you know, sit on a set of The Buzz.
He's so sweet. Mwah. My baby.
Anyway, anything you want to say before we leave?
No, I want to go to sleep with me now.
He's tired. He didn't look tired the way he was walking down the aisle. This is all I got to say. Bye, you guys. Follow us on Twitter and Facebook and do it all. Bye. Oh, the Buzz blog site is coming soon. That's it. Bye.
Walk for me.